Guys, in this video, I want to talk to you about how to build a hot box. Basically, a unit to keep your batteries warm and your caulking and glue from freezing. So the question I have for you is, how do you keep your caulking, your glue, your drywall, mud, primer, paint, whatever, from freezing? Well, it's starting to get cold here in Concord, Massachusetts, and it's time when I have to start to think about what I left in my truck and what I really need to unload at night to protect it from freezing. For example, I usually bring in my caulking and glues to protect them from freezing in a 5-gallon bucket or a milk crate or something. And you know, at the end of a long day, the last thing I want to do is unload more crap just so I can load it back in again in the morning. You know, it's starting to sound a lot like that movie Groundhog Day, right? Just repeat cycle. I needed a hot box. Now, a hot box, it's basically an insulated box with heat. It's going to keep your caulking and glues and stuff at either a desired temperature, if that's what you need, or from freezing. You know, for years I would take my caulking out and leave it on my dashboard and leave my truck running and blow heat on it to keep it warm or unfreeze it. A few years ago I was working a large window job, an installation, and we used a cheap styrofoam cooler with a light bulb. And we kept our caulking in it during the day to keep it, you know, so it would flow well. It worked great, and I stored that idea away because I wanted to make a permanent solution for my trailer. I'm sure we all have versions of job site hacks and versions of these, but you know, all getting us to the same place. But I wanted a permanent, reliable solution. So since my trailer has a shoreline, it's hooked up to my house, and I can hook it up to a job site, I figured I'd make a permanent hot box that I could use electricity with. To size my box, I decided I would insulate it with 1-inch dowel rigid insulation. That's gonna give us an R5 insulation value, and this box is out of the wind and snow anyway. In order to add heat, I decided I would use a 40-watt vibration service incandescent bulb. And I may downsize that, I don't know yet. I didn't want the bulb running 24/7, so I wanted to control it. So I purchased a digital temperature controller, and I set the low and I set the high temperature for the interior of my hot box. The controller controls the power outlet on the controller, and in that I mounted a bulb with like a plug socket to plug into it. And that's it. I mainly wanted to keep the hot box for caulking, glue, and wood filler, but in retrospect, I wish I made it larger so I could throw some of my batteries in there as well. That would have been genius. I still can, I suppose. I just don't have a ton of room for a lot of batteries, but I could certainly get my starters in there. Look, to size my box, I added 4 inches to a tube of caulking, basically, on each side. So basically 4 inches, 2 inches allow for an inch of dowel insulation and an inch of airspace on either side. And I'd be lying to you if I didn't take into consideration how much plywood I had. That's kind of how I got the box size. Final dimensions, 14 by 14 by 14. Approximate, that's inside dimensions. The hut box construction, it's not fancy. I used a table saw to size all the parts, including cutting the rigid insulation. A finish nailer was used, and it was just used quickly to put the box together, following up later with 2.5-inch deck screws. Once the box took shape, I cut and tightly fit rigid insulation. I used insulation board adhesive to hold everything in place. And for my sides, I wanted a shelf. So I used insulation to the height of my shelf, and I put 3/8 plywood for the shelf just to keep the spacing down. And I purposely kept the shelf 1 inch off the back wall and the front wall to allow airflow and heat rise. I placed the temperature control in the far back corner, and that's to protect it from damage and allow heat to rise up that back shelf. I didn't want things hitting the bulb up front. And I also kept the bulb 1 inch off the insulation for, you know, obvious reasons. I may go back and add a piece of step flashing or something as a heat shield under the bulb. I don't know yet, I gotta check that out. I also added kind of a stop of rigid insulation in front of the bulb to prevent bottles, glue bottles, from hitting it. Let me see. Okay, for the door, I just added insulation to the door. I fit it pretty tight, and I used 1.25-inch screws and 1-inch washers to hold it in the insulation adhesive in place. And that's gonna hold it until the adhesive dries, but also gives it extra support. For the cord of the controller, I just drilled a hole through the back, pushed it through, secured it with cable staples, and then I just carved, I coped some insulation, and I covered the hole in the wire, and then afterward, I just filled in the remaining void on the back of the box with caulking, just to stop airflow. Not perfect, but tight. To finish off the box door, I used a recycled piece of piano hinge I had left over from a project and an extra window sash lock. I really like the sash lock because as you turn it and close it, it pulls the door nice and tight. All right, let's talk about the temperature of the hot box. What's the sweet spot? Well, ideally, caulking wants to be used anywhere between 45, and that's low, up to 70, 80 degrees. And these temperatures, they're gonna ensure the caulking hardens correctly and sticks to the surface adequately. It's recommended that when applying caulking below 32 degrees, that you pre-warm the caulk to 70 degrees. And they want, you know, keep it nice and flowing. Wood glue application or manufacturers require a 70 degree, or they recommend it, but it can be applied as low as 55 degrees for glue. Look, I'm sure you're like me and you violate these rules and recommendations sometimes, and that's why I'm building a hot box. And I'm sure you have trouble keeping things from freezing or cold. So I'm still experimenting, but I set my temperature control at a 60 degrees. That's my turnoff point. And it'll turn on at 40. So 40 to 60 is my range. I field tested it outside. Now it was like 28 degrees. The house was 28, the deck was 28. The box itself was like 30, and the inside of the box temperature was like 50 degrees, which was perfect. When I first set it, when the bulb turned on, I came back 5 minutes later and it was already off and up to temperature. So it heats up fast. So far, so good. I'm looking forward to setting this up in my trailer and getting field use out of it. Look, I wanted a permanent solution. This whole project maybe took me 3 or 4 hours to build. It took me longer to wait for the stuff to arrive, the controller in the mail. I'll throw a purchase link in the article and in the video below on this controller if I can find one. And I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it solves problems for you guys. If you liked the video, please consider subscribing and leave us a comment. We'd love to hear from you guys. I'm Rob Robillard, and we'll see you next time here at Concord Carpenter.